Are your Amazon products ranking high in Amazon search, but maybe you are unsure about your PPC strategy? In this video, you will learn how to maintain a balance between the PPC spending and organic reach, and why it is crucial to stop running advertising on high-ranking ASINs, which might be causing you additional cost. And in general, if you need help with PPC optimization and automation, check the M19 tool, link in the description. And now let's jump to the video.
Hello, Tarik. I'm really excited to have you back here on Orange Click channel with me today to talk about one very interesting topic regarding products ranking very high organically and what sellers should then do about their PPC strategy. But as always, before we go into the details, could you first introduce yourself and also let us know what M19 is and how do you help with Amazon sellers?
Hello, Lisette. So my background, I'm an engineer, a machine learning engineer. I started in the advertising space 10 years ago already. I started my Amazon advertising journey 5 years ago as a co-founder of M19. I am the CEO of the company. So for people who don't know about us, M19 is a retailware ads optimization software, which means, in simple words, doing automating ads and optimizing ads, not only using ads data, but also using profit analytics data, inventory, rankings, SEO, market data, etc., etc. M19 is an advanced Amazon partner. So this is the highest tier into Amazon partners. So and the last nice recognition we got recently is we were the winner of the PPC Automation League this year by David Zimmerman, for people who knows him, mainly in Europe.
Let's go straight into it, because I know you always have very good insights to share that our audience loves. So I'm also eager to learn from you today.
Perfect. So this is exactly the topic in a very simplified way. So this is first, this is page number one for Kettle Research. You can see that the brand with the product in green is displayed twice in a sponsored position and in an organic position. So this is what we will try to avoid doing. This is what we want to do. Instead of displaying the same product twice in the sponsored position and just below in the organic position, we would like to push other variations within our catalog to occupy the same space with two different products from our account, trying to maximize our chances to increase sales on other products and also to improve margin on some other products. We will get into more details for that. So let me start first with one key concept that we need to go through before diving into the strategy. The concept is about how we balance between PPC and organic rankings and reach. First thing to keep in mind is that maintaining top keyword rankings organically can influence the need for PPC spending. What that means is, in some categories, if not most, you will need to run ads in order to protect and maintain your organic rankings. So this is pretty important to keep in mind. Now Amazon is pay to play. What the other second concept that we will be using is, we want to reduce PPC bids for the same ASIN that is already ranked well organically. We want to reduce bids in order to avoid the situation I showed you before. So two main things. PPC is needed to maintain organic. Second, we will only touch and change PPC for specific ASIN on specific search term. It's always both ASIN search term, and I'm talking about child ASIN, not parent ASIN, child ASIN search term, where you are already on top organic positions. This screenshot is for one product variation, one ASIN variation. You can see different search terms. So each line is one search term. They are ranked by SFR, which means by popularity. The higher lines are the ones with the higher search volume, and the one in below are the ones with low volume. So for the first search term, we can see that organically, this is ranking over last 7 days. So we see the trend over last 7 days. We see that organic rank was increasing until reaching page number one. Here, when it was page number one, you can see that unsponsored sponsor ads stopped. While they stopped, you see that the ranking, the organic rank stopped dropping. And you see the final dot here, which represents activating back ads because organic ranks dropped after stopping PPC. The second line is the same. In green, it means we did we took the right action, which means again, when we are page one or based on strategy I will share later, or line one, you stop PPC, there is no PPC, or you drop it. And when it hurts organic, when it drops again, you activate again PPC. This is why you see a sponsored rank dot. And the last red line is exactly what we will try to avoid. So you are all the time number one organic and number one sponsored over the last 7 days. But the how do you call it? People that make that spots small details will tell me, hey, yeah, but this is the last line of your screenshot or your table, which means that the search term is not very popular and it's not a big issue. And yes, you are right. This is why PPC was not stopped. You don't want to have this on the top search terms where you have a lot of traffic, which means that you have a lot of PPC ad spend. At the bottom, on the long tail, you kind of don't care because this is time consuming and complex to put in place. But just to show you the big picture, 1-1 is not something that you want to have on your high volume search terms.
And one question, Tarik, before you move on to the next slide.
Yes.
Just to clarify for the viewers, so this view or this dashboard we're currently looking at, I would say it's super clear. I understood straight away what you're explaining about, and I would understand by looking at these graphs, like what to do and what not to do. It's not something that Amazon provides sellers, right? It's from your software itself.
Yeah. This is an extract from one of our tools, like we call it Product 360. So on any ASIN, you can have different tables, graphs, scorecards, and widgets with different data. And I just pick one variation with a screenshot on the rankings visualization for this ASIN. And by the way, the Product 360 is you can use it for free in M19, except some areas of it, but you can already have a lot of value from the free version of Product 360. Now let me present to you one of the strategies I recommend to for keyword ranking and bid management. This is the one that we implemented within the software. Of course, you can do it in different flavors, but this is one of the strategies that you can have. First, it starts with daily keyword tracking. You need to be able to monitor daily. So you need to have a system that monitors daily your top keywords for each ASIN variation. This is a starting point, sponsored and organic. If you want to be a bit more advanced, this you can remove it if you want. You need also to be able to track the ratio of your mobile sessions compared on a daily basis, compared to desktop sessions. Why you want to do that? Because ASINs that are mainly traffic on mobile, top rankings are like the threshold is different from desktop. In desktop, lines are like you have different items. Mobile below the fold or above the fold is smaller. Then you want to determine an organic rank cutoff based on who is predominant, mobile or desktop to make it easy. If you have more than 50% sessions on mobile, your cutoff, organic cutoff threshold should be 3. If your main sessions or majority, more than 50% of sessions are on desktop, you can consider higher cutoff at 6, because above the fold is larger. By the way, these metrics, most of the analytics tool provide them, like the desktop to mobile sessions. And I think it's also available directly in Seller Central. Otherwise, again, it's also something you can get for free inside M90. Then in terms of bid adjustments, you need to regularly, which means daily, check organic and sponsored rank. If both organic and sponsored ranks are below the cutoff, let's say your product is mainly mobile, so the cutoff is 3. If your organic and sponsored are both below 3, you need to divide by 2 for this specific search term, for this specific ASIN variation, you divide by 2 the bids. If sponsored rank is above the cutoff, don't change anything to the bid. What does it mean? If your sponsored rank is above the cutoff, it means that you are in top line organic, you are not on top line sponsored, and you are either rest of search or other page on sponsored. So there you don't do anything, because you don't want to get even lower. You want to keep yourself in rest of search in case someone didn't click on you where you were in top positions and they click after. And anyways, it's cheaper rest of search. This is what it does mean. Then when you are able to cut by half your bids where you are both under the cutoff point, you need to keep an eye on your organic rank. Why? If you remember, sometimes when you stop PPC when you are top organic, organic might drop. And you want to see that quickly. As soon as you drop from line one organic, you need to revert your action and multiply by 2 back your PPC bid. So it seems pretty simple. It's mainly tracking, deciding of a cutoff based on mobile desktop. Then when a condition is met, divide by 2 or not, keep an eye if organic drop, re-multiply by 2. But the reality, it's complex. This is why I was saying in the beginning, do it only for your top keywords. Make sure you do it per variation. And if you are not using an automation software or a rule-based software or a bulk upload option to manage your PPC, just forget about this, because you won't be able to do it manually in Advertising Console, because either you will make a lot of errors and it's boring, and you will stop doing it after a couple of days. So it's only for people who are already pretty advanced in automation, either through a software or bulk upload. Lisette, how am I so far? Is it was it clear, or?
I think it was clear, because I think it's a very important topic actually to talk about. And although it's a bit maybe more advanced, I think a lot of sellers should really review their ads from this perspective, because maybe you as a PPC expert can tell us, like, if you kind of don't think about it and you just like run ads for a keyword that you're organically ranking like on top anyways, of course, the sellers are going to lose money, right? Because what do you think customers, do they even pay attention to if they click on the sponsored placement, let's say like a sponsored product or like a first organic? They probably just click what comes, you know, out as first, and they don't really care about like if the seller has to pay for the click or not.
Yeah, no, you are completely right. So most of the cases where this happens, either you are aware of it, the seller is aware of it or not, there is cannibalization happening. The cannibalization is different from one category to another. By cannibalization, I mean someone who was already going to pay and buy your product did it while clicking through your sponsored links, and he would have done it without this this ad. What you want to avoid is when you stop PPC where you are already good organic, you only want to remove this cannibalized sales and keep the ones where, if you are not there, you let another product or another competitor, you will lose the sale even if you are there organic. And finding the pure incremental sales there is hard, if not impossible. And what we are doing is just trying to optimize it. To be transparent, some categories, when you do this, it doesn't work, which means, let me show you after. Yeah, we will get into more details here with the expected outcome. It doesn't work in the sense that as soon as you drop PPC, you lose, even if you improve your profit on the organic, on the sales that you are making, you lose over the total and competitors are getting more sales. This is why the last step of keeping, and when you usually when you lose sales, it impacts negatively your organic rank. This is why it's really important when you do that type of optimization to be very cautious about what's the impact on your organic. And as soon as you see a drop or a hurt in organic, you stop doing that and you accept to have the overlapping. What to expect? So usually there are two like different things to expect. Your top sellers that are on a lot of top organic positions and the rest. So on the top selling variations, ASINs, you should expect the share of sponsored sales to drop. So sponsored sales should drop if done properly, which might seem scary. So if you look at your advertising console or a PPC tool where you look at sponsored sales, you will see a drop, which is not a big deal. What you don't want is total sales drop. If your sponsored sales drop and the share of sponsored sales drop in your total revenue, this is fine. So you do it properly, sponsored sales drop. And you should see an improvement in profit margin. So of course, to do all this, you need to be able to have your P&L and profit analytics per child ASIN and variation level. So sponsored sales drop, share of sponsored drop in, and profit margin for this variation should increase if the strategy was successful. The margin, there should be some other margin dynamics on the other ASINs, not top selling ones. So you should see a decrease, or your margin on the other ASINs will be worse. Why? Because if you do it properly in the top sponsored position, you will stop pushing top sellers and you will start pushing the other non-top sellers. To push the other non-top sellers, it's more costly. It will cost you more money than before because it costs less to push a product that is already well selling. So you will be increasing the PPC management on your non-top selling products. So this is why, in theory, you will hurt at least for the short midterm your margins on this non-top selling products. So this is also something to expect. The last one is how the revenue is distributed across your catalog. If also done properly, you should see an increase in the proportion of revenue that is made by non-top sellers, which means that your non-top sellers are growing, because when you are reducing PPC on top sellers, you are giving them more room to get more exposure and to grow. Of course, all this will happen if your non-top sellers are a good product, but this is also a result to be expected, like the revenue distribution over all your catalog.
And here, are you meaning products that are relevant in terms of they have similar or basically identical keywords in it, right?
Yes and no. So all the strategy, all the reasoning and everything is independently if they have the same keywords or not. So you do it at search term product. The impact, like the smaller scope of impact is, yes, what you are saying. If you look at a subset of relevant search term that have shared ASINs to whom it's relevant, you will see this dynamic at this level. But you cannot witness or measure profit at search term level because you don't have revenue at search term, you don't have FBA cost or whatever. So there are dynamics that you cannot measure outside seeing the rankings and sponsored sales at search term level. But what I'm referring to here is that at account level, when you check variation per variation, you should expect these margin dynamics and total sales distribution per variation.
Okay, sounds good. And I think that was also your last slide for the day. So thanks again for giving us a detailed overview. I think for me, it was clear. So I hope it's clear also for our viewers. But if anyone has additional questions, then leave them down to the comments and we can ask Tarik to come back and answer those questions as well. I think I don't have a question regarding to this exact topic, but before we go for the day, we are recording this near to the end of year 2023. Not sure if it's published this year or next year, early next year. I wanted to ask from you, like, what's one of your main tips or takeaways for sellers for the next year in terms of how to excel with PPC advertising on Amazon or something to take from this year to the next year and focus more on?
If I have just one thing to take from this year is you cannot afford anymore to do advertising or PPC looking only at your advertising data. And this is why I found like topics addressed by Orange Click very interesting, because there are so many external factors, like the one that we were discussing during this video, but there are others that have a strong impact on your PPC. So one thing is, whatever you do with your advertising, you need to keep an eye and have your inventory, profit, rankings, and market share data very close to your PPC strategy or PPC tool or whatever. You need to have these four very close. And of course, the listing, like what's happening on your listing. You cannot take that out of what you are doing on your PPC, what to expect from it, how to measure and analyze your results. So this is what I would give to people if they want to put in place something for next year regarding advertising on Amazon.
Okay, so it sounds like a good call to action to watch all of our other videos as well on Orange Click YouTube channel, not just the PPC ones with you. But yeah, I guess PPC is something that you can't manage in an isolated way anymore. So I think that's a fair point to share and hope sellers will follow your advice as well. So before we go, so you briefly talked about M19 and we saw like a dashboard of one of the features the tool has. Can you give us an overview of what kind of solution do you offer for Amazon sellers and maybe for what type of sellers your software or solution is the best fit?
Yes, so our software is suited for sellers, vendors, and agencies. So the main audience here is sellers. It is suited to small sellers that have very small spend, couple of hundreds or couple of thousand a month, to sellers spending a million a month. And we have some of this, it exists. It's always scary to see these amounts spent. Like the philosophy of our tool is not for everybody. So machine learning style automation, it's very different from rule-based and full control systems where you want to have a control at bid level and decide how you want the bid to be moving. So there are two different schools. We are on the school of people that want to scale, automate, and optimize using algorithm. And there's the other school. Both, they work pretty well. So our software is for small sellers to very big one, For small sellers, we have plans that are free, because we understand that you cannot, and we, it was a request from the beginning. When you are new or small, you cannot afford to pay a software, and it's our way of giving. So we help. Maybe if you grow, you will need more advanced. You will pay for a version on M19. So there is the automation that is you need to pay for the advanced management for bigger budgets. Small ones is free. And all the analytics and reportings and dashboards, this area is free. So it's like Google Analytics and Google Ads. Google Analytics is free. When you want to activate and do ads, you pay. This area, you can all sellers can use it for free. Profit analytics, inventory, everything like season advertising, all this data is accessible in a pretty easy and advanced way.
Sounds really good. And yeah, if you're interested to learn more, then we also have link in the video description below. So go ahead and check it out. Well, it was great to see you. Thanks again for sharing everything you know as a PPC expert. And I hope to see you soon again.
Thank you, Lisette. Bye-bye.
I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you want to try M19 tool for yourself, check the link below in the description. And if you have additional follow-up questions, use the comment section below, as well as if you enjoy what we do, don't forget to hit like and of course subscribe to our channel. And now I would like to invite you to other video where you will learn why it's important to focus on profit margin and not on ACoS when you are evaluating your PPC performance.